はい、ドレミの歌知らない方はいらっしゃらないと思いますね。ドはドーデンさんのドと ということなんですけども、サウンドオブミュージックね、はい、それのジュリー・アンドリュースさんが来日をしまして、ドーデンさんが、ね、大変素晴らしい話を聞いてくれました。
そのサウンドオブミュージックが発表された年に私は生まれているんですが、最近ではそのジュリー・アンドリュースさんは王様と私、ミュージカル映画になりましたが、そのレコーディングを終えられたところなんです。お目にかかった時からお別れする時まではずっと笑顔を絶やさずお話をしてくださったジュリー・アンドリュースさんの歌とお話、どうぞお聞きください。
Well, Ms. Andrews, it's been more than 25 years since you first starred in The Sound of Music, and I should think that your fans are very anxious to know whether you have changed or not changed at all. What would you say?
Well, I hope I've changed a little bit. I hope I'm a more wise woman, and I hope I've grown up a little bit, but I think somewhere deep in my heart I'm still the same a little bit.
I see. So I feel very honored to be meeting Eliza, Maria, and Mary Poppins at the very same time today.
Thank you.
Do you see any familiarity in personality in those characters?
That's hard to answer in a hurry. I think perhaps in The Sound of Music, some of the joy that Maria has is perhaps mine, because I do get a lot of joy out of life. And Eliza, in My Fair Lady, is a sort of fighter, and she strives to be better. And perhaps that's a little bit true of my personality also. You'd have to ask somebody that knows me. It's hard to speak about yourself.
I see. Very recently you have finished a recording of The King and I. Many people must have asked you, but why now, after so many years?
Well, really, why not? Because I have been asked if I would travel with a show of The King and I. I was asked if I would go out on tour, and it was never convenient. I always was either busy with the family or I had something else on my schedule. And so this time they asked if I would like to make the recording, and it had the blessing of the Rodgers and Hammerstein Foundation, who are the wonderful composers of The King and I. And I simply said, when do we start? Because I've always wanted to do it. And the music is so beautiful and the words are so lovely. And it's another timeless theme.
I see. Well, you said that the theme was timeless and the music is at the same time timeless.
Yes, it is.
Do you have any hopes within you, kind of, that wants to preserve those goodness in music?
Oh, I think so. Those kind of classics must be preserved. And there's a whole generation of children out there that don't know who Rodgers and Hammerstein were, and they don't even know this music. And so it's wonderful to be able to bring it back fresh again.
Shall we dance on a bright cloud of music? Shall we fly? Shall we dance? Shall we then say goodnight and mean goodbye? Or perchance, when the last little star has left the sky, shall we still be together with our arms around each other? And shall you be my new romance? On the clear understanding that this kind of thing can happen, shall we dance? Shall we dance? Shall we dance?
You are taking part in the activities of the United Nations as well.
Yes,
I heard.
Yes.
And what do you think you can do in your own capacity for the needy children?
Well, I'm in a unique position because I am able to, I do have a fairly high profile, and so I am able to speak, and I have a voice that is heard. Right now, I'm a goodwill ambassador for a wonderful fund called UNIFEM, which is the United Nations Development Fund for Women all around the world. And it's really for the advancement of women in developing countries, women who still can't get up off the ground because they have so much work to do and they are so poverty stricken. But I believe that if you help 400,000 women, you automatically help a million children and their families. And so I'm very proud to be associated with this group of people.
I presume you are spending very busy days within a year, being an ambassador, a singer, an actress, and also a mother.
And yes, a mother and a wife. That one comes first.
Does it?
Oh, yes.
Well, do you think you feel you sometimes have to give yourself a break, kind of, to escape from the busyness of your daily?
But we try to stay together as much as possible as a family. My husband is a wonderful film director, as you know, and so sometimes we try to make a film if it's convenient in the summer holidays when the children are not in school. And we try to travel with him, or he travels, or they travel with me when I'm working. It doesn't always work, but we try.
Do you have any specific plans for the future, the coming future? There's so many things you want to do still?
Lots, oh yes, always. But I do have one specific plan, and that is for work. Next year in March, I will be going back to Broadway in New York, and I will be doing a limited engagement in a show of music by Stephen Sondheim, who is perhaps the top modern composer for Broadway right now. And so I will be doing an evening with four other people, and we will be singing his songs. It's a limited engagement, but I'm very happy to be doing it.
So we shall be seeing you sing and act?
Oh, yes, I think so.
Well, I personally feel that I would love to see you sing to your own grandchildren, maybe.
Thank you. I have two grandchildren. So, no, I have one and one on the way. Mm-hmm. So I hope you're right. I hope I do that.
Uh-huh. A lullaby, maybe? A sweet lullaby?
Yes, that would be very pleasant. Oh, yes.
ドイさん、頭混乱するんですが、はい、さっき「シャルウィーダンス」歌いましたね。あれは昔のレコードなんです。30何年前の。
いや、もうごくごく最近のジュリー・アンドリューさんの歌声で。
だってあの歌声は今の歌声じゃないんじゃないですか。だって今もう57歳になるんでしょ。
57歳ぐらい。
昔と同じじゃないですか。
そうですね、もうびっくりしますよね。
あれ昔のレコードに合わせて口パクパクやったんじゃない。
いやいや、決してそうではないんです。
皆さんすごいね。
すごいですね。
これは孫はもう2人目の。
そう、孫2人、ね、
います。なんか全然もう生活感がないっていうか、浮き彫らないしてる方、なんかすごいですね。
あのツヤツヤした歌声といい、この感じといいね。
なんかあのお話の中の登場人物のような、なんかそんな印象がありますよね。
どうですか、ごめんかって疑いませんでした？これちょっとおかしいんじゃないか、なんか違うんじゃない、
信じられないような感じいたしますよね。ただ何ですか、その歌声にしても、あの存在そのものが、なんか何回でも読み返したい本のようなね、なんかその懐かしさがありますよね。
いや、懐かしいどころかびっくりしましたね。でもね、高齢化社会で来てますからね、あの、まあ、57歳なんかまだ年じゃない、もう全然年じゃない、これから頑張れるんだっていうことを彼女は僕たちに教えてくれたんじゃないかなと思いますね。
金さん銀さんもいますしね。
まだ先だ、金さんまではまだ、あと半世紀ありますからね。
でもその家庭をすごく大事にしてらっしゃるってお話の端々からも分かったんですけど、クリスマスが近づいてますよね。で、家族だけでやっぱり過ごされるんですって。で、ただし一人だけ特別で、サンタクロースだけ特別に招待してありますって、なんかあのお孫さんの喜ぶ顔が見えるようですよね。
まあ、英国のね、あの、ロイヤルファミリーのようにいろんなことがありますけど、非常に健康的な文化を持っている、非常に素晴らしいな